Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to His Works. And today we are going to do a portion of these analogous pairs from the verbal section of the GAT or qudrat exam. Let's get right into it. So the question is, complete the analogous pairs. In the first one says scribble, write, stammer, question mark. So basically, you can think of it as a scenario. In school, you would not scribble. You would write on your paper. In school, you would not stammer. You would what? You would just speak. And stammer has, you can't apply stammer to walking because stammer, the definition of stammer, is speaking with sudden involuntary pauses. So it's something relating with speaking. So it has nothing to do with play and it has nothing to do with dance. It has something to do with speaking. So without even knowing the correct answer, you can know it by the process of elimination. Now let's go to question number two. Question number two says flower, bud, plant, question mark. So basically, a flower comes from a bud. So what is a bud? Let me draw for illustration. You know when the flower basically has not completely bloomed yet? This is a very bad drawing. This is not a tulip. It's supposed to be when the flower has not yet bloomed yet. This is a bud, okay? And when the flower is like open and everything, please excuse my drawings. When the flower is open, it's called a flower. So basically, a flower comes from a bud. So what does a plant come from? Does a plant come from a taste? No, it has nothing to do with that. Does a plant come from a flower? No. Does a plant come from a twig? Twig is basically like a wooden branch. No, it does not come from that. So we can infer that a plant comes from a seed. Because when you plant seeds, you get plants or whatever you plant. Trees, flowers, etc. Now let's go to question number three. Question number three says, rate books, flaws, question marks. So first, we have to look at the definition of errate. What is errate? Errate means an error in printing or writing. Even without knowing the definition of errate, we can look at the derivatives. Errate, have you ever heard of errate? I think it comes closely similar to the word error. So we can infer that it has something to do with a defect. So there's a defect in books. More specifically, if you know the definition, an error in printing or writing in books. So where are there flaws? Where do flaws usually happen? Flaws happen on a certain object. They happen on objects. They don't happen on certain things. So flaws happen on objects. We know that. From that, we can cancel out speech because speech is not an object. And then we can look at the manuscript and charter. Manuscript and charters basically mean the same thing. And when they basically mean the same thing, you cannot have two answers. Meaning you can cancel these out because there are synonyms. Leaving us with metals. And metals is the answer. Why is metals the answer? Because metal is an object. And flaw, when you're looking for a flaw, you're looking for a flaw in an object. I know this question is actually pretty hard, so I would advise you to look into it and search the definitions if you don't know. And yeah, ask any questions in the comments. Let's look into question number four. Question number four says gun, bullet, chimney, question mark. You can think of it this way. What comes out of a gun? A bullet comes out of a gun. What comes out of a chimney? A house does not come out of a chimney. A ground does not come out of a chimney. A roof does not come out of a chimney. That means smoke comes out of the chimney, leading us to D being the answer. Now let's look into our fifth and final question. We can do this. So it says, breeze, cyclone, drizzle, question mark. Before I get into it, since it is the last question, I will give you a chance to do this. So please pause the video and take a look at the question and try to do it. Okay, so it says breeze, cyclone. What is a breeze? Okay, so a breeze is something, as I drew here, it's something like that kind of in the wind, just like a little breeze. What is a cyclone? A cyclone, on the other hand, is more intense. It's kind of like this. It's kind of like a, I guess, a tornado, but it's not. It's has to do with water. So what we can infer from this question is that it's asking the more intense version of this. So a drizzle. A drizzle is kind of like a little bit of rain, right? So what is the more intense version of a drizzle? The more intense version of a drizzle, first we can go by the process of elimination. Earthquake has nothing to do with a drizzle. A drizzle. A storm has... I know it relates to water, but it's still not the answer, because a flood has something to do with, like, excessive flooding, you know what I mean? But that is not the answer. That's not what we're looking for. We're looking for something that comes from the sky, okay? Because drizzle comes from the sky, we have to look for the similar one. A storm. A storm, I can see why you could choose the answer, but it's not the answer. Why? Because let's look together what the correct definition of a storm. So a storm is disturbed state of an environment or an astronomical body's atmosphere, especially affecting its surface and strongly implying severe weather. Okay, so a storm, we know that this is going to mean like lightning and thunder and whatnot. And we are not looking for that. We still are looking for something relating to water. So we can cancel that out and infer that D is the answer. Why is D the answer? Because it comes from the sky. First of all, that's our first rule, coming from the sky. Second of all, it's the more intense version of a drizzle. So leading us for D to be the answer. We are done with today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and this is WizWorks.